Okay, today I'm showing my Raspberry Rover project, and basically what it is a Wi-Fi controlled robot that you can connect to and can control it. It's made by Clayton Richard, and at the top, the URL, I'll make an annotation for that so you can get to his website. Other than that, basically all right, now I'm going to show you the wiring schematics for it and how it basically works is it runs off of a couple of 10 point or 6 AA batteries. It has a power on and off switch, a DC to DC converter for Raspberry Pi and the motor driver, and the Raspberry Pi can only take so many volts. That's about 3.3 volts before it'll give out, and then the motor driver needs at least 5 volts before it can start running DC motors. And basically what the Raspberry Pi is doing is it's making your turning your code into signals that can be picked up by the motor driver, and the motor driver turns those signals into analog electrical signals that are sent to the DC motors, and the DC motors pick them up and send them to the motors, and the motors turn, and the whole thing goes, and with that such. Right, over there, that M, you can see that's the webcam servo, and basically it allows you to attach a webcam to move it up and down, to see where it's going, when and wherever it's at, whether it's under things, stuff like that. It also has some IR lights that is plugged into a copper board, and those run off of the same power source, and that's about it. Here's a side and top view of it. On the side there you can see some ribbon cable. I didn't have that, and he didn't specify that I needed that, and I didn't think I needed it until the last minute. And so my final project wasn't done, but if I had that, it would have been. Here's the top view of it and things like that. Here you can see a better view of where the cable pins are, and those just are where the digital signals are sent to the motor driver. This is where he had it plugged into, and that's a copper board that he has it soldered into, and that plugs into it, and above that is the motor driver. Here's the rover code that he built, and it does have a few bugs, but other than that they can be fixed very easily. Basically it just tells what when you send a command over terminal, what type of what direction you want it to go, where you want it to go, how far you want it to go, and things of that nature. And here is the controller code which you would use on the computer that is connected to it via you connecting SSH routing into the Raspberry Pi to control it over whatever network you're on or whatever network it's on. Here's the Java to C++ sockets. This is for the server, so you have to run this. He ran it off of Windows, and that's what I did as well. And you have to run it off of Visual Studios. And what it does is it allows you to compile it, and it's made by Keith Vertinen. Here's the GPIO utility. This is for getting the Pi wired up. This is essentially allowing it to talk to the motor driver and things of that nature. Here's the Java UI interface, and that's just when you SSH into it, you're able to talk to it through a window or through like a terminal or some sort of window using putty or whatever you're using, just being able to send a command, things like that. Here's the robot chassis that I used. It's not very, well, it's kind of big, but it's not too terribly big. And here's the motor driver that I used, and you can see on it, they specify where what goes where for pins or for motor drivers or for DC motors and things like that. Right, here is where I got the Raspberry OS for Raspbian. It's at raspberry.org, and I'll make an annotation for that. What I used is Raspbian OS, and it's what you use to run the Raspberry Pi for the image. It's also what Clayton Richer uses, and a lot of people use this. If it doesn't download the first time, either retry downloading it or find another website that will let you download it in a in a dot image file, because I had major troubles with getting it to download an image in an image. All right, here is my project plan that I had hoped to follow, and essentially what I really wanted to do was build the rover, but also learn about C++ and Python coding in that nature. And I did kind of do that, not a ton, because a lot of it was already pre-built, but other than that, I did somewhat get through building the Raspberry Pi. Tasks that I had hoped to accomplish, I just wanted to get everything ordered in the first week and show her that, show my teacher that, this, see that I was on track still, and get everything ready for the Raspberry Pi to be set up and ready to get everything on it. Second week, I had hoped to get most of it, most of the Raspberry Pi and computer stuff put together, but I had a lot of trouble the first week just getting the image to download and getting the image to get to the SD card. Third week, I had hoped to get everything pretty much put together, Raspberry Rover thrown together, all that nice and neatly tucked up inside of it. If there's really anything I could do to redo this, it would have to just be have better planning than what I had planned for. Like, I need to really just make a calendar events for what I'm going to do each day and try and get them accomplished for each day. Here is the motor drive. It converts the Raspberry Pi's digital signals into an analog signal, so it can convert it to from digital to analog. And analog is just a an electronic signal that these DC motors can pick up, a positive and negative side, and they're all hooked up. They hook into the bottom half of this, and each thing is categorized with A01, which is motor port 1, which converts it from this. This side is the all sides green. That's the side. These are the IR lights that are part of it. They help the camera see when you go into darker places. So, greens are negative and reds are positive. And there's supposed to be a 58 ohm resistor in between each little bit. There's holes, and they each connect to essentially, they go from ground. From LED ground to ground with Raspberry. All right, and this right here is the main chassis
of the rover. It's the Raspberry Pi would be on this underside, and it would stay housed in here. In each little bit, this part would be with it, along with IR lights, which you can see here. With the IR lights, and then on top would be the servo would be connected up here along with a webcam, and then battery pack along with DC to DC converter for the for this motor driver, which takes 5 volts, and the Raspberry Pi only can take 3.3 volts. So.